practice as a Muslim, and I am proud of my religion, which is Islam. Okay, and one of our brother in the Gambia, who you know, he's a celebrity, and he was doing a music show or a music album, and this is what he did. I'm going to show you this, but if it offend you, I apologize. Okay, this is the guy. Okay, this is what he did. And this guy here, he is a Muslim. So he did this. So, and some Christian feel it's offensive to them. And you know, they are complaining. And some Muslim also came out on social media. They were complaining. Okay. Let me tell you a bit about myself. Okay. I am not representing you. I am representing myself. Okay. I'm talking about me. Let me tell you. The time I was around 9, 10, 11 years old, I was very ignorant about Christianity. I was very ignorant. I did not know too much about Christianity. I thought that, and I don't know about religion tolerance. I did not knew it. I'm talking about me. I'm not talking about you. So some of you, because you don't use your brain, I want you to listen to me. I am not saying I'm apologizing. I'm talking about you. Okay. And then, by the time I remember, I saw Christians with the cross. They were walking around in Brikama, in the Gambia, where I live. And I was among of people who were stoning those Christians. I took a rock. I was stoning them. I was calling them names. You Christians, you are going to hellfire. Christian, fuck you. Christian, this. I did that. But I was ignorant. And I did not know. And I want to apologize this. And I want people to understand, sometimes, you know, we are human beings and we are ignorant. I made a mistake that time because I don't know too much. What I know today about religion, what I understand about Christianity, if I knew that 20 years ago, I will not do that. And I still regret why I did it because I don't even know too much about religion. That's what I want people to understand. Okay? This brother who did this, you know, he did not know that when he did it, it's going to be like what happened today. He did not knew it. This is what I want people to understand. We are human beings. Sometimes, you know, it's okay for this kind of stuff to happen to one of us. At the end of the day, we can all learn from it. Let me tell you, this cross and this picture, I did not know that it will offend Christians. I don't even know. Okay? But guess what? What I did, because I know some of you are attacking me. Some of you are attacking me about this picture. I saw your attack. But now, for me, what I did, I sent this to a Christian friend back home. So my Christian friend told me, okay, you know this. So I was asking him, are you offended by this? He told me, yes. I tell him how and why. He told me, okay, nobody should do this. You know, because it's disrespecting our Jesus, blah, blah, blah. So he started to explain it to me. Which now I understand. But what I want people to understand is the guy who did this, he's a Muslim. But he is not representing me, neither my religion. He is not representing us. But he is still a Muslim. He is still our brother. But I'm so glad that he made a mistake. And he come out and say, hey, you know what? I apologize. I did not know if I did this. It's going to be what it is today. And this is what we should encourage. When people make mistakes, let them come out and apologize. Okay? And some of you so-called Muslims, you are taking this picture. You are posting it on your Facebook. It's fine. You don't have to post this on your Facebook anymore. The guy made a mistake. What we should do if our Muslim brother sister did a mistake. Let's come together. Let's, you know, help the guy. Tell him, hey, go out and apologize. But I saw some of you are insulting him, calling him names. You are this, you are that, you are smoking weed, you are on drug. It's not going to help. The best thing that can help is let's try and educate big, I don't know, one pack or two pack. I don't even know this guy. I don't even never see him. I just saw him on social media like you guys do. I don't even never talk to him. But the best thing we can do, you know, if you know him, you know, tell me, come out and apologize. And, you know, but some of you are putting gas on the fire because the more you took this picture, you spread it on social media, you calling it name, Alba, you guys are creating more problems. Okay? So I think it's enough now because the guy came out and apologized. And he said, you know what? I did not know this is going to happen. Let me tell you. There is one journalist called, I think, Charlie Abdul in France. This France journalist, they caricature Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Since this newspaper, they caricature Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in France, I was offended. Yeah, I was offended. Let me tell you that. I was offended. So now it's the same thing as this thing too. You know? So now it offends them. So, but the best thing we can do is to acknowledge that this Muslim brother, he is one of us. Let us not push somebody because he made something, because he made something stupid. Yes, he is one of us. But he made a mistake. And he is not representing none of us. He is not representing us because he made a stupid mistake. You know? So, Charlie Abdul think it offend me. I see it as, you know, that's what's so rude for you to take our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and caricature him. So it's the same way, the way it offend you is the same way it also offend others. That's why it's okay for us to understand that big pack or two pack or one pack is one of us. Okay? People need to understand this. Nobody is perfect. The time I was young, I was calling Christian name because I did not know. I'm talking about me, okay? Because, you know, I was talking to a Christian friend. And today me and him, we were talking, and he told me that, you know what? Somebody want to help me to get something, but he refused to help me because he knew that I am a Christian. That is the only reason, you see? Me, before I come and talk, you know, I have a lot of friends who are Christian. I call them. I do my research. I talk to them. But he told me that I find it that some people are discriminated me because I'm a Christian in the Gambia. Because I'm a Christian. And this guy, he's supposed to help me. I know he got it. He can help me. But finally, he knew that I'm a Christian and he refused to help. You see? So, some of the Christians are saying that because of other people are caricaturing them or calling them names just because of, you know, we're disrespecting them. And you know, it's true, you know, it's happening but those people who are doing it, you know, they are ignorant. Okay, they are ignorant because me also before I was ignorant about Christianity and religion tolerance. God say in the Quran, as a Muslim, you need to have tolerance. You know, let be tolerant to others. Okay, God say in the Quran, lakum dinikum waliya din, follow your religion. Respect your religion. Respect other people's religion. It's very clear. But the time I was young, I did not know about all these things. And I did not do my research. So I'm very glad now, alhamdulillah, I did all my research. Now I know about Christianity. Now if I have any issue that I don't understand, I can call my Christian buddy. Hey, what do you think about this? He can just, you know, help me to understand what he think about this. And I want to let my Christian brothers and sisters to know in the Gambia and around the globe, this brother is one of us. But we apologize for his action. People need to understand there is no bad religion. We just have bad people. But there's no bad religion. We just have bad people. In every religion, you have good people. We have bad people. But sometimes today, a Muslim guy will do something wrong. They will go and frame the entire Muslim if one Muslim guy is wrong. They will frame the entire Muslim. Oh, Muslim are like this. Muslim are... No! All of us are not the same. If I did something wrong, you need to blame me. But you don't need to blame my religion, which is Islam. If I did something wrong. And today, some people are fucking ignorant. Yeah, there are some Christians who are ignorant. There are some Muslims who are ignorant. But people need to understand that. That's why today, if something happened, they will go and caricature, Muslim, their religion is violent. Muslim are this, Muslim. No. There's no bad religion. If I did something wrong, blame me. You don't have no right to go and blame my religion, or you don't have no right to go and attach my action to my religion. My religion did not, my religion condemned violence. Any kind of violence, it condemned it. Any type of violence. So people need to understand, if I did something wrong, You need to blame me, but you don't need to go and blame my religion. And I hope my fellow Gambian Muslim brother and sister, we will all learn from this. Okay? And it's good for things like this to happen so that it can bring awareness. You can learn from it. Because me, I don't even know that it was not okay to do this. But now I learn it. And I'm so glad that the sponsor, because this one park supposed to play at a concert. But the sponsors also withdraw their sponsor if this guy is going to be there. That was so awesome. So I want to thank Kiusen for that awesome job what they did. Sometimes we the Gambians, you know, especially we the Gambians who are famous around the world, you need to set us example like we do something wrong. Okay, the sponsors also can say, okay, we can withdraw. We are withdrawing our sponsor. Okay? Okay, we are going to withdraw our sponsor. That's good. Okay? So now, One Pack also supposed to play at this show. So now, Kiusen say, if One Pack is going to be there, they're going to withdraw their sponsor. Now they remove One Pack from that show, which is fine. Which is okay. Okay? So, I hope people like me and other Gambians, we will all learn from this. Okay, you cannot say this. You have to respect people's religion. You have to respect people's freedom of speech. You have to respect people's right. Okay? So, what Kiusen did there, they did the right. And I also hope One Pack also know his mistake. But it is what it is, you know. So, and it was meant to happen, and it happened. So, I hope, we can all learn from this and make sure when we see something like this, you contact the person as soon as possible and tell him to delete this. You don't have to put this on social media. You are making an error. You made a mistake. You are doing this. That also can help, okay? So, just like what I said, before I start my show, and I'm going to repeat it one more time. I am apologizing to all my, as a Muslim and as a Gambian, I'm apologizing to all Christians in the Gambia and around the globe for what our Muslim brother did. It was a honest mistake. It was a honest mistake. He did not know. If he knows, he's a grown man. If he knows it was not okay, I am 1,000,000% sure he will not do it. So just to let you guys know, I'm not here to debate with anybody about Muslim and Christianity. I'm just here to raise my concern about this incident. So if you have something to argue with Christian and Muslim, you can go and find somebody. So that is not my purpose. Go back to Dara, Baba Ja. You are still blind about religion. Okay, I think I need to block this guy here. Give me 1 minute. Give me 1 minute. Okay. Give me 1 minute, my people. That's good. Religion tolerance is very, very, religion tolerance is very important to me, you know? So that's why I just blocked this guy, because he put something nonsense about, you know, about Christians, which I don't think it is okay. That's why I just blocked him right there. And on my platform, if you come here, all what I need is for for you to respect other people's religion. Okay, respect them. Okay, people have their right to say whatever they want. Okay, yeah. So if yes, I agree with you. Let's promote tolerance. That's what Islam say. That's what Islam say. We have to respect. Tolerance is very, very, is very important in Islam. Tolerance is very important in Islam. But some of us are ignorant. So that's why, because there are some stuff, you know, you can just let it go just on behalf of tolerance, you know, because of they don't know, you know. So, and I hope to. Kiusen also can forgive One Pack to come back to the show. I hope because QCell did what they should do to remove him from the show. But now he apologized. Somebody even tagged me the video where he was apologizing. Give me 1 minute. Let me just block this idiot here. I don't like to have idiots on my Facebook wall. You apologize and every other apologize accepted. Thank you so much. Okay. As a Christian Paul Korea, thank you so much. I'm so glad that you guys accept our apology. Okay, so you know we are who we are. We make mistake. We make stupid mistake. Okay. Patrick says sharing chap actually bought one pack. He know that is no, he did mistake. In Kerifatu. Yeah, he know he made a mistake, but he apologized. So that's why I'm saying I hope QCell sent a very good example. I am so glad what QCell did. They sent a very example. It's the same as America here. In America, like a famous person or celebrity, you do something stupid, the sponsors, they took their sponsor. And this is very important. Okay, QCell is promoting is tolerance. QCell is showing the Christian community that we are with you on this. We are with you on this journey. We are not going to let nobody to disrespect you. We are not going to let nobody to disrespect your religion. This is what QCell has did. I want to send a big hug and big thank you to the management of QCell. I don't know who bring this idea. But they did a very awesome job. And I want to thank them so much for what they did to Big Pak or Tupac. I cannot even say his name. But I also hope that, you know, Ngabula Kaneng, let us stop taking this video and spreading it and insulting him. Let's try to enlighten him and apologize them. Let them know that our brother made a mistake. It's a honest mistake. It's not going to happen again. We apologize you, blah, blah, blah. It can help. It can help. Hey, you know. If somebody did something wrong to you, okay, the person apologized you. You know, come on, man. You know, accept your apology. I'm a human being. Jalba kuyate. Jalba kuyate anyine fa. Ako ninga haketu mas. I diamo ban nimfente kono. I am sorry. I am sorry. I diamo ban nimfente kono. But maybe some people, because of they hate one pack, they will use this opportunity pour ka gena discredit, pour ka gena neng, pour ka gena bully, pour just to try and bring him down. That is not the thing. One pack a mistake, okay? Sign the Alhamdulillah, alayas hakilola, molfana munia contact, munia contact, yaso hakilo one pack for another. I apologize, I attend the call, you know. It bring a. Video is about 7 minutes more a screen record. 7 minutes I am forwarding it. You know, I can feel it through one part. He was so sad and he was not okay. Yeah, I feel it. I can even tell through the video one part ning I have busa fong. He feel it. Yeah, so I know going to happen now, and it's okay for what to do things like this to happen. Okay. So I want to thank each and every one of you. You know, I hope, you know, we can continue what we are doing, you know, and I want to and so the Christians in the Gambia, we are with you. We will not let nobody to discredit you or to call you names, okay? Especially people who, you know, they are celebrities who are well known. If you guys can remember the time Yaya Jame said that he will take the graveyard of the Christians next to the arch, I was among of people who came out and condemned Yaya Jame not to remove those dead bodies there to come and build a hotel there, because you know they are dead body. Okay, we need to respect the dead. Okay, and it happened also in Tanene. Christian, their cemetery. They want to somebody want to grip and take that cemetery and say that cemetery belong to me. We have dead people there. And I know as a Muslim, if Muslim dead body were in that cemetery at Tanene, that Muslim brother will not go and say that I'm going to take this land back. There are Muslim body in there. We need to respect dead people. We need to respect each other's religion. That is what Islam asks us to do. Lakum dinikum waliyadin. And as a Muslim, I am here still not to apologize you, to let you know that we are with you. We made a mistake. It happened. Our brother did it. And he is still our brother. And, not because he made a stupid mistake, we should abandon him or we should call him name. No, he made a stupid mistake. And I hope my this video also can help. Okay, to my video also can help. Okay, and we don't have bad religion, you know, we just have bad people. Okay, thank you, each and every one of you. My name is Dr. Babaja, aka Seven Chapatole. I am the voice of the voiceless. God bless you all. Thank you. Hallelujah.